Hello, YouTubers, fellow hams, 3D printing enthusiasts, and whoever else might be watching. It is winter here in the desert. I'm still in Kingman. My plans to travel south this season and hang out with the Rat Pack down at Senator Wash didn't pan out. Several factors weighed on my mind I had to think about. The RV needs work. It wouldn't be responsible of me to try and take it on the road as is. Especially with my health in the state that it is, I'm still not strong enough to drive myself that far. I get about 3 hours in the morning now, sometimes four, where I almost feel normal, which is when I'm recording this now. I've had people comment on the previous videos, it's nice to see that you're better. Or that you're healthy again. And no, I'm not. I'm better. I'm not healthy again. I'm better. I get about 3 to 4 hours in the morning of near normalcy. And then it's pretty rapidly downhill from there. And the fatigue really hits hard. The headache and tinnitus and the difficulty concentrating comes back on. And I'm done for the day. Usually by about 10 or 11 in the morning. I appreciate the well wishes and the good thoughts, but no, I'm not healthy again. I'm getting there. A little tiny bit of progress every month, so still improving. But it would have been irresponsible of me to try to travel and try to take this RV 200 and some miles south. I had friends that volunteered to help with driving it down there, but there were other factors, other issues with the RV that need to be addressed, and I'm not strong enough to address them yet, so I decided not to go. I'm staying here this winter. My friends all went. I am going to be alone for about 3 months, completely by myself, which is okay. Some people don't like that. In past videos, when I talked about spending time completely isolated, I had one viewer that was just horrified. He said, how could you possibly do that to yourself? That's terrible. No, it's different for everybody. I'm kind of a loner, kind of a hermit. So for me, being alone is not that big of a deal. And I've got the radio, and I've got internet and connectivity to my friends, so I can call on the phone, do voice calls, video calls, you know, so it's not like Jack Torrance in The Overlook. How many of you got that reference? But it's not going to be too bad. Video production. I had a few bursts of energy where I've gotten a bunch of videos done in a short period of time, but it's been a rough November. One of the doctors put me on different meds, and they hit me pretty hard, so it was a really rough November. I managed to get a few videos done, but I've been using my energy to knock items off of my long to-do list. One of those items, several years ago, I started to experiment with end-fed half-wave antennas. And I used Steve Ellington's design for the 49-to-1 match network. And at the time, I was just experimenting, so I threw together this monstrosity. I just built it on a piece of old plastic cutting board as a temporary test rig, you know, to test the antennas. And it worked really well. And I was reminded of something that one of my Patreons said to me a while back about something else. He said, "Nothing is so permanent as a temporary fix that works." And kind of true. This thing is really ugly, but I've been using it for several years, and one of my items on my to-do list was to rebuild this properly and cleanly. And so I've worked on that a little bit. I designed this nifty little enclosure here. And this is for a 49-to-1. It says it right there on the side. Another copy of the same thing says 9-to-1, because I'm also going to wind a 9-to-1 to put in this, and so I'll have two of these. Using a T43-82, I think it is, core, type 43. This is one that I wound up for the choke that I dropped. there's another container for the choke. Okay, and this has a female BNC on one end. I've ordered some panel mount male BNC connectors that'll go on the other end. So yeah, these little enclosures I designed, these are going to be companion pieces to something like the ICOM 705, the Yaesu, what is it, FT-DX10, the smaller rig, the 10 to 20 watt range radios. Although the prototype is up, and I pushed 35, almost 40 watts into it without issues. So using these small cores, the wiring that I'm winding the cores with is a twisted pair out of an old piece of Ethernet cable. And I've got the rest of the parts, mostly the capacitors I'm waiting on. I use one out of my junk box for the prototype. But I'm getting a list of Amazon links for the parts so that I'm going to put together a PDF file. And anybody can then download the models, print the little enclosures, and order the parts and build it themselves. So it's going to be a set, three, as I said, companion pieces to go with one of those low-power radios taking the field. So they're nice looking. Oh, they got a neat little feature on here. This loop is for paracord, so you tie your paracord onto there to take the load off of the coax. And at this end, there's a little loop integrated for the antenna wire. So you bring your antenna wire in, loop it around itself, connect it to there, and then put it on the terminal. So neat little features. There's also a gasket. I printed a TPU gasket. I'll show you a picture that you can apply on here to keep moisture out. So if you can print TPU. So there's that item off my list, rebuilding that ugly 49:1. Another item off of my to-do list was the CW Flea case, the CW Flea transmitter that I co-designed with Harry over at Zactech. Three years back. At the time, I just threw together a 3D printed case in Tinkercad just to get something out there for it. And I wasn't too happy with that case. And one of the things on my to-do list was to do a new case for the CW Flea, which I have done. Here it is. So this has nice front panel, better buttons. That's where you can see the LEDs. Nice back panel. Four screws at the corners to mount the top on. Key jack on the side. Where is it? Oh, it's over here. Key jack on the side. That's our call signs, Harry's and my call signs. And of course, the CW Flea logo in the top. So yeah, a real nice little case for the CW Flea. That's all updated and up on Thingiverse. So that's another item off of my to-do list. So that's what I've kind of been spending my energy with, is doing that. I had a message from a guy, probably a new viewer, that just, you know, hadn't been watching the channel for long, that recently that asked me, he said, "Are you pivoting your channel from ham radio to 3D printing?" Question mark. No. My channel has never been strictly a ham radio channel, or a 3D printing channel, or an electronics channel, or a travel channel. It's never been strictly one particular facet. It's the old tech guy channel. I do tech stuff. I do a lot of ham radio videos. That's kind of the primary audience and the primary content. But it's not strictly a ham radio channel. If you go back through my catalog, I've got well over 500 videos that I've done. The early ones are not very good production quality-wise because I really didn't know what I was doing. Pretty terrible, but the content's okay. But if you look at my catalog, I go in bursts of things. For ham radio, there was a period of about 4 months where I was just doing antenna videos, and I had a few comments from people saying, "Oh boy, another antenna video, gee," sarcastically, you know. But I go through cycles of things, and these last couple of months, two things have happened. One, I upgraded my 3D printer, which was another thing on my to-do list. I got a Prusa MK4S. I wanted to get a top-of-the-line, dimensionally accurate, reliable printer so I could focus on design and know that my models are dimensionally correct when I upload them. you know, so I wanted more of a tool and less of something I'd have to fiddle with. Yeah, a lot of people said you should get the Bamboo Labs. I don't like their ecosystem, the way that they're tied to their online service, where, you know, all your models go through their Chinese server farm, and it's kind of at that the mercy of that. You can print to it directly, but it's really heavily tied to that. What I like about Prusa, and it's my philosophy in general, is they're an open architecture. They're open source. Their software, Prusa Slicer, is open source. Their firmware is open source. Their hardware is open. They provide printable models of all the part files for their printer that are printed. I mean, not the metal frame, but they're an open design, an open architecture, and fully offline. You don't need to use their cloud service. You're not tied to any of that. And that philosophy works for me. I like the freedom of open source. All of my utilities are open source. The operating systems on my computers, the software I use, the design software I use, the graphic software I use, everything that I do is open source. There's no commercial software. And I get along just fine. And I know that if the internet went down tomorrow for a month, I would get along just fine. So that's, you know, and that's my personal choice. I'm not saying that's how you should do it. I'm just saying that's the way I do it. But that's why I went with the Prusa. And the other thing that happened is I got my mind around Tinkercad, or not Tinkercad. Tinkercad's what I've been using for years. And I will still point a brand new 3D printer user that has no experience with CAD, I will still point them to Tinkercad immediately, because it is so easy that you just put shapes together. You know, somebody brand new to the hobby will be able to have some success making their first models and not be put off, you know, and that's where Tinkercad is great. But I've started to get my mind around FreeCAD. The 1.0 release is out now. It is so much better than it used to be. It's got wonderful auto constraints and things in the sketcher, so you can sketch your design up much more quickly without having to punch in 30 constraints. They're automatic when you're sketching. It just makes it so much easier, and it is so powerful. Oh my gosh. Learning FreeCAD has untied my hands. I had no idea how limited I was with Tinkercad. And, you know, if you're a Tinkercad guy, that's fine. Don't attack me and say, oh, you're bad-mouthing Tinkercad. No, I'm not. Tinkercad is great. FreeCAD is an order of magnitude up in capability and power. There's no arguing that at all. Look at this parametric utility box I just did. So this spreadsheet is actually a function within FreeCAD. It has a spreadsheet workbench, which I'm on now. I'm going to go back to the part design workbench. So here's my model of my utility box, and all the dimensions are here, and the sketches in the model all reference these dimensions and each other to make this fully parametric, meaning if I change a parameter over here, like the box width is now 68 millimeters, let's take that down to 50 millimeters. And when I do, you see how the box changed? Let me take the length down to 80. And you see how the box changed? It regenerated with the new parameters automatically. So I can change the width, length, depth of the box, the screw size, the screw pocket depth, the wall thickness. It's 2 millimeter walls right now. If I wanted to make that, say, 3 millimeter walls, boom. Did you see how that regenerated? The walls got thicker. And everything recomputes. These pads sizes recompute. Let's change the screw size from 3 millimeter to 4 millimeter. And you can see the pad sizes here increased to accommodate the new screws. So everything is recalculated based on these dimensions. And not only this box, but also a lid that also regenerates, and an optional gasket that can be printed in TPU, a flexible filament. So you can have a gasket as well to go along with the box. And every aspect of this regenerates based on these values. So it's fully parametric. If I wanted to increase the radius on the corner fillets, these curved corners out here, watch this. Boom, do you see them increase? I want it to 3 millimeters for the fillets. Let's go down to 2 millimeter screws, really small screws. Boom, see how small those pads became? So yeah, everything is fully parametric. So isn't that cool? Anytime I need a project box now, I'm just gonna load that file, punch in the dimensions, export it, print it, and I'll have a box. I also, as you know from previous recent videos, did a really cool planetary transmission for magnetic loop antennas and another herringbone gear transmission for magnetic loop antennas. And little things that I've done. I did a stylus caddy for the CC Nano VNA that I just reviewed that keeps the stylus on top of the unit. And little things like that. FreeCAD is amazing. Absolutely amazing. And it's not that hard. There's just a little bit of a learning curve now. You just have to learn how to think CAD. And it's not that hard. There's a great series of tutorials from a channel called MangoJelly. I'll put a link to his beginner tutorials in the video description. If you're interested in FreeCAD, go there and start watching those. Download it and start playing. You'll pick it up like that. The capability is just amazing, what it can do. That's why over the past 2 or 3 months, there's been a weight that has shifted over to the 3D printing stuff for now. And that's not going to last that long. I'm going to pivot back to ham radio stuff here. I'm working on, these are ham radio. This is crossover. This is 3D printing and ham radio. This is 3D printing and ham radio, you know? So there's a blend. And I've got some radio stuff that I want to do, I'm starting to do. So, I might even do a couple of videos where it's just me playing on the radio, making some contacts. That magnetic loop I built, I brought it into the house. I'm mostly living in the house now since it's getting cold. As you can tell, it's 42 degrees, 44 degrees Fahrenheit here in the RV this morning. Kind of chilly, and it's going to be below freezing next week. So I brought the magnetic loop into the house, and I've got a little spot there with a chair next to the big picture window, and I brought the Azu FT817 in. So I might do a video next week of just making contacts, just playing radio on the magnetic loop. Why not? I haven't done one of those in a while, and I want to get on the radio. So no, long answer, no. My channel is not pivoting from subject A to subject B. It's always been a blend of these subjects. It just does that. And right now it's kind of leaning towards the 3D printing stuff, and it's going to swing back, and some other things might pop in there, some electronic design stuff, I've got some ideas there. Some things I want to build, So as I get more energy, the video content's going to increase, and it's going to be a blend of things as it always has been. Okay. I think I've talked long enough for this vlog. I know these are not the most popular videos. There's a few people that really enjoy these. A lot of people are saying, "Oh, why'd you waste my time?" Well, why'd you watch it? It's in the subject. So anyway, thanks for putting up with me babbling for a little bit. I just wanted to bring everybody up to date on how things are going. And I'm going to get back to nibbling away at these projects. These antenna matches and the choke, I will probably have them done by next week. The rest of the parts are showing up today and tomorrow. So these will be available on Thingiverse and printables probably in a week, along with the instructions and the parts list. And I'll probably do a video detailing their use and showing them off. I've done some whisper testing with the design. It works great. They're really nice. So that's coming up. And whatever else comes along the pipe. I've got a 2.4 gigahertz Yaki that a friend of mine let me borrow, and I've got a CC Nano and VNA that goes up to 3 gigahertz. So I'm going to put that Yagi on the VNA and find out how these cheap Yagis actually look. That might be interesting. All right. That's what's going on. We'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Also, if you're not already a subscriber, click to subscribe. Join us on the Facebook channel for discussion about the videos. And if you'd like to help support this channel, please click to support me on my Patreon page.